the seismic, as part of that process, has identified that the target depth of the well originally was, I think, 3,200, and now it would appear that we only need to drill to 2,900 because the Heavitree formation will be intersected at a shallower depth. So that's the first important thing.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. Joining me is Georgina Energy CEO, Anthony Hamilton. Tony, very good to speak with you. You've announced a big resource upgrade at your Mount Winter prospect. Tell us more on how you got there.
Good morning, Stephen. Well, the resource upgrade at Mount Winter has been as a result as a very detailed reprocessing of the seismic data, which took a considerable amount of time to reprocess, considering the scale and size. But then, of course, once you've reprocessed the seismic data, you've then got to essentially interpret what the results mean. It was a very long and expensive process, but what it's done is it's opened a horizon for us on a number of fronts, not least of which the increased resource, but also the potential for another structure.
Tell us about the increased resource. What are you seeing there now, Tony?
Well, in terms of, if you remember, the original seismic is 2D and the resolution is very poor and it's over 40 years old. When you reintroduce it to the latest technologies that we now have available 40 years later, it's able to improve the resolution significantly. And what it's done is it's seen us get about a 15% increase in the net attributable 2U resource for helium and hydrogen, and about a 3% increase in the natural gas or hydrocarbons structure. So now people should also remember that that is what they call net attributable. So at present, legally, we only own 75%. But in reality, once we complete the purchase of Oil Co, that will increase to 100%. So then our net attributable increase, and this is quite complicated, will become 100%. So to put that into perspective, the new resource 2U or P50 for helium is 127 at 75%. If we go to 100%, it'll be 169. Hydrogen is 117. When we go to 100%, it'll be 156. And when we go from 944 of the hydrocarbons to 1.25 TCF. So you can see that the numbers increase significantly, but obviously we can only report the net attributable as it presently legally stands.
You've also identified a new 60-kilometre square structural closing. So that, I suppose, offers future exploration potential then, Tony?
It does indeed. Within our permit area, obviously the Heavitree formation and the field in the Northern Territory is highly prospective. You have to remember that the three wells that did penetrate the Heavitree formation saw concentrations in excess of 9% helium and over close to 12% hydrogen. So this structure is 60 square kilometres. It's massive. And obviously the evidence or the existence of it was unknown to us and to our competent person until the seismic reprocessing took place. But it certainly provides something which we would consider will require further investigation once we've re-entered Mount Winter and developed the asset.
So what's next? You're planning that re-entry and you're also progressing your exploration permit negotiations, Tony?
Well, in fact, the seismic, as part of that process, has identified that the target depth of the well originally was, I think, 3,200, and now it would appear that we only need to drill to 2,900 because the Heavitree formation will be intersected at a shallower depth. So that's the first important thing. Second thing is that we are presently obviously working on our re-entry planning and engineering. And then, of course, we are working with the Northern Territory government and the traditional owners on the ALRA, which stands for the Aboriginal Land Rights Access Agreement. That's progressing extremely well. And obviously, once that's all been finalised, it'll be submitted to the minister, and the minister will then grant the permit. So, it's all work in progress.
Tony, I see you've also launched a new website. Tell us a little bit about that.
So we put out an RNS yesterday, and our new website actually coincidentally went live today with this announcement. Our old website was 6 years old, and although served a purpose, wasn't as cohesive or as informative as it should be. So we engaged a company called Luminate, and they have done, I believe, quite a spectacular job on our website. It's a lot more investor friendly, a lot more interactive. It's actually got some rockets on it taking off, which of course the element of that is the significant usages of helium in the launch process. So yeah, it's we're quite pleased with it, and hopefully the shareholders will find it extremely useful and very informative.
Give us your web address, please.
It's www.georginaenergy.com.
Definitely worth a look at that. Tony, as always, a pleasure speaking to you. I hope you'll keep us posted on any additional progress.
Thank you very much, Stephen.
That's Anthony Hamilton, the CEO of Georgina Energy.